Hello, my name is Kylie, and welcome to Three Kinds of Resources. In this video, you will learn about three different types of resources, how they are made, and how they are used. It has a lot to do with economics and money. Ready to learn about resources in our economy? Let's take a closer look. Our economy is a system of making things called goods and providing services. It also is how we go about trading, buying, and selling these goods and services. Economics is a study of how we make, buy, sell, and use things. The use and moving around of these items is an important part of economics. These things are called resources. Take a look around you. What do you see? No matter where you are at this moment, you are surrounded by resources. Are you at a desk? The desk is made up of wood, and that is a resource. Did you take a warm shower or bath? Water and the energy to heat it are resources. What are you watching this video on? A tablet, computer, phone? The people who make these devices are actually resources. Let's take a look at three different kinds of resources that are all around us. The first and perhaps the most important resources we will discuss are natural resources. Natural resources are things that are found in nature and not made by man. Sometimes it is easy to overlook or not notice natural resources because they are so much a part of our everyday life. Water is one of our most precious and important natural resources. We use it for so much. Other natural resources include rocks, land, the air we breathe, trees, wind, sunlight, plants, coal, oil, and more. There are some natural resources that are renewable. These resources can be thought of as never being used up. These include sunlight or solar energy and wind energy. We can collect solar power with solar panels that collect sunlight from the sun and turn it into electricity. Wind also can be used to power windmills called wind turbines, which also make electricity. We cannot use up solar and wind energy ever. Most natural resources are non-renewable. This means that once we use them up, there will be no more of that resource. For example, oil, used to make gasoline, plastic, and heating oil, is found deep, deep underground. There is a limited amount of it. Once we use it up, it will be gone forever. This also affects the price of things made from these resources. For example, the more oil we use, the less there will be of it, and the prices of gasoline will keep going up and up. Some types of non-renewable resources are gold, which is used in jewelry and electronics. Iron, used to make all sorts of tools, cars, appliances. Coal, which is burned to make electricity. Salt, used for food and is also essential for humans to be healthy, but not too much of it. Chalk, which is commonly used to write, but also in manufacturing some items. Lithium, used as medicine and to make batteries. Neodymium, which is used to make magnets. There are many, many more than this. Non-renewable natural resources must be carefully conserved. Conserved means to only use what we need, find ways to use less, and protect what little there is left. Trees are a very good example of this. We used to cut down trees without even thinking that there would ever be a time that we could use them all. This is called deforestation. Unfortunately, we know this is now not true. Governments and businesses are trying to find ways to use less trees to make things out of wood and paper. Recycling and reusing items made from paper and wood is one way that we can all conserve this natural resource. Also, planting more trees, which take a very long time to grow, helps to make more. This can be a little confusing. You may say, well, then trees are a renewable natural resource, right? Well, technically yes, but we classify or group them into the non-renewable category because humans use them up faster than they can grow. That is why it's so important to conserve this resource. You may notice items made of paper and wood are getting more and more expensive because as we use more, there is less to be found. The less there is of something that people want, the more expensive it becomes. Let's take a look at the second type of resources. Human resources. Yes, you are a resource. Humans are resources because we do labor or work. Of course, there are a ton of different types of jobs humans do, from computer technicians, cowboys, to carpenters, and from dentists, to doctors, to decorators. All are human resources. Think of something you love to eat. I love vanilla ice cream. There are a lot of people involved in making the ice cream. The farmers who raise the cows, the people who harvest the vanilla beans, the people who work at the factory that make the ice cream, truck drivers to transport the ice cream to the store, store clerks to stock the freezers, and the cashier that takes your money when you purchase it. That's a lot of people. They are all human resources. The last type of resource is called capital resources. These are things like machines, tools, vehicles, and information people use to do their work. Remember that delicious vanilla ice cream I talked about? The tractor the farmer used to bring hay to the cows, the huge ice cream machine, the forklift the factory worker used to load the truck, the freezer the clerk put the ice cream in, and the chart the cashier used to check the price of the ice cream are all capital resources. All three types of resources, natural, human, and capital, are used together to make our economy work. Let's see if you can identify which type of resources these items are. How about a school bus? Which type of resource do you think this is? It is a capital resource because it is a machine. In this case, a vehicle. Humans use to produce a service, which is taking kids to and from school. Okay, think about a pencil. Which type of resource do you think this is? Did you say capital resource? It is. You use a pencil to do work. Therefore, it is a capital resource. How about copper, metal? Think carefully. Which type of resource do you think it is? You're right if you said natural resource. It comes from the ground. Now, here is a challenge. Do you think copper is a renewable natural resource or a non-renewable natural resource? That's a tough one. The answer is non-renewable because once we use up all the copper out of the ground, there will be no more to be found. We will only be able to recycle the copper we already have. And last but not least, what are you? Yes, you. You're right. You are a human resource and one very smart one at that. I'm so glad you learned about the three types of resources with me today. Remember to practice what you've learned using our fun online games and quizzes. You can also learn more about economics in our other videos on this topic. Until next time, be resourceful and always be clever.